institution that brings together graduate engineers to further the profession of engineering and to maintain standards of engineering as it's applied in Jamaica.
Yeah, and someone might ask, well, I'm asking, what would be the role of an engineer on the coastline? I mean, is water and stone and all kind of things.
So it's water and stone, but you know, how you put the stone together on the coastline could make a difference between whether the stone washes out or whether it stays. So there's engineering behind that. And that particular discipline of engineering is coastal engineering. It's a sub-discipline of civil engineering. And so, you know, there's a need to understand the waves that are coming into shoreline and how you can build to protect the shoreline and infrastructure against the damage from those waves.
Yeah. And Sir Vice Priest, that holy pass stones that we see on Palisados, that's exactly what we're talking
about. Correct. That's an engineered structure which we call like a revetment.
What do you call it?
A revetment.
I said earlier that... and I'm not here to, and that's what we're looking at, but I'm not here to give anyone a hard time. But I read in the opening that things could have been better and maybe we would not have had the outcome that we had in the western end of the island. Is that so?
Well, it's easy for us to assume that. And generally, as engineers, we try not to knock each other unless you've actually evaluated the full numbers. And in many cases, there are varying constraints. Some of the constraints is tied to the financing that the government may have to execute a project. As we know, everything costs money. And what we're trying to do is to manage risk. And there are varying levels and ranges to the risk as well. And so in that context, what you may find is that an event may exceed that which was affordable at that point in time. And that's why we would see something that looks like this as well. So those things have to be factors. A number of factors have to be taken into consideration when applying a structure or a solution to a problem.
My words, penny wise, pound foolish?
I wouldn't say that.
Hard to say, you know.
No, and by that I mean, should we not have kind of put it before things happen and then we jump in? That's, which is why I said. And again, I'm not here to give anyone a hard time, but we're trying to find solutions, aren't we?
I think it was a very unusual event.
Yeah.
Because of how it started, you know, there was a storm over North America. It caused high winds for a number of days. So we had winds blowing over a length of sea between Gulf of Mexico and Jamaica. It's over 1,200 miles long. It's a long stretch of sea. And so when the waves got here, they're big waves. And so that sort of event, the length of time that the wind blew for and the distance over which it came is an unusual combination, right? So maybe once every 30 years, something like that.
So is that a suggestion, Mr. Vice President, that even if we had what we should have had, it still would have happened?
Well, we can't stop the event, right? Hazards happen all the time. The mitigation towards that, we can in a regard. But again, it comes back down to financing, comes back down to a number of options that comes into play. So could we have built a wall that was 10 feet high that could prevent it? Of course. But then now that has to be balanced with the fact that people want to see the beach. People want to access the beach. So there's always a balancing act that we're trying to play in terms of the engineering solution along with the use of the facilities and things like
that. When I said penny-wise, pound foolish, I was kind of suggesting, and I'll stay with you, sir, that were you guys called in when, you know, just like what's happening out at Palisades, where you guys call in and say, well, these things could happen, so how do we mitigate? Or no?
We weren't called in.
Should you have been called in?
After the event or before the event?
Before the event.
Well, before the event, it's always tricky because you never know what's going to happen. And there are freak storms or freak events or strange phenomena that may take place that you can't always cater for every parameter because you could have a combination of events that take place at once as well.
My point, Dr. Ellis, is that if you're going to build, you need building codes and you need...
Yes.
That's my point. Yes. So my point is if we are on the shore, should we not call you guys and say, how are we going to ensure,
that's a fact.
If something happened, it not going to hurt the place, it not going to kill nobody. That's my point.
Okay,
yes. So while there are building codes which are very well defined for structure buildings, hospitals, high-rise apartments, they are less well-known for coastal structures, but nevertheless, they do exist. So as Dr. Ellis has said, it's really, what it boils down to sometimes is how much risk is the developer or the government wishing to take on in terms of building the particular piece of infrastructure.
Yeah. You know. Have you now been called in to help out and kind of try to ensure, because you said you can't tell, try to ensure that if this happens again, at least what we saw, the aftermath, we won't see that again?
Well, we haven't been called in directly, but we know that as a body, we have a point to play, and we should advocate, we should create awareness, which is a big part of our theme for this year. Bring awareness to the whole factor, speak with the business sector, and of course, continue the research and development, which are the three main tenets that we're going through.
Does that mean you should call them?
That means that as professionals, we should take the lead.
Right.
You know, we don't wait for the call. We want to go and start to do what's necessary for the safety of the populace as well.
I don't want to use the word simple, but is it the same thing that you would do at Palisades, just put up some stones and that's it?
Well, you're right to say you wouldn't call it simple.
Right.
But we can't say yet until the engineering is done. So one has to go through detailed assessment to determine what's the most suitable solution for a particular area. There are varying factors that comes into it. There are hard solutions, which is what you'd see at Palisades, and you could have soft solutions like mangroves and things of that nature, seagrasses. And the corals would have helped or generally helped in terms of breaking some of that wave action that comes in. So maybe there's some issue like that. We may have to do some offshore structures as well.
Final question, Dr. Smith. Hindsight is 2020 vision.
Yes.
Is there any other area in our country that we need to start looking at now in case something like this happens?
I think we should look at the areas that are most populated.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So in other terms, so yes, we do have water issues in terms of flooding and that effect, and we also have issues on the line in terms of high rise and all these things. So we are, as a body, looking at all of that, and more is to come in the near future through the Developers Forum series and other events that we have for this year of engineering.
Yeah, man, thanks for coming. Thanks for your service. Thanks for your service.
Thank you very much.
It's so important. All right, past president of the Jamaica Institute of Engineers, Dr. David Smith, and Dr. Leighton Ellis, vice president of engineering affairs. After the break, we journey to Trenchtown Culture Yard. What a segue. Stay with us, please. Soon come.